Ophelia, I would like to compliment you for being a really good friend, and when somebody needs help, you help them.
From the first day they walk in, I'm getting to know them as a child, a person, and I'm getting to know them as a learner. The first couple of days were pretty play-based in my first grade classroom, because just watching them interact with other students, watching them interact with materials, tells me a lot about those kids, who they are, what they like to do, and just daily conversations. Like every morning, I am telling them about my life, they are telling me about their life. We have a quick minute to check in every single day. And I think that's woven into our curriculum too, you know, giving them some choice in the books that they read. I know exactly what they like to read about. In Writer's Workshop, you know, they're writing about their lives and we're sharing that writing. So we're getting to know, I'm getting to know them and what they like to do outside of school. And I'm modeling with my own writing about my family and what I like to do. And we really start to build that relationship.
One of the focus is to be able to know the kids outside of the classroom.
There you go, Tegan.
And for example, when for writing, we talk about I Am From poems. We write I Am From poems to really kind of dive in to their stories outside of the classroom and the stories of their families. That kind of really gives the students a chance to bond and giving them a chance to really share what their families are about and even what their culture is about. And so utilizing the students and their families to educate the entire class.
Hey, Harry. Hey. I need to see my students as just, they're human. They're not just students of language arts. Absolutely they are. But when they come in here, they come with a lot of stories. I think one of the things in my journey of working well with students is learning that I need to show them that I trust them. Well, even before learning that I need to show them that, I needed to trust them. There's that humanity that we all have inside about wanting to do well, about wanting to not just survive, but have a great life, right? And so when I remember that, then I trust them.
My commitment was to be a good listener, because I think that that's the key thing to having a good relationship with the kids, is being there to listen. Another one is knowing everyone's name, making sure I say their name right. Because I feel like if I don't say their name right, I feel like I'm taking a part of their identity.
So, Miguel, how do you start the game?
My name is kind of confusing. I have two first names or two last names, as you say it, and sometimes people will mix it up. And so I explain that. You know, I don't want people to mess up my name, and I don't want to mess up your name. Because it's important to use people's names to show respect and show you know them. I think that's important culturally as well. I have another student in class who's Ukrainian. And the first time I misspelled it, he just kind of rolled his eyes. And I was like, oh, this matters to him, that I spell his name correctly. And so when I know kids like that, we have this connection that helps me build that relationship that allows me to push them as learners as well. So once I have built that relationship, then I can ask them to do the challenging work that I'm asking them to do in the classroom as well.
As a first-year teacher, the most important thing I've learned about relationship building is that if you have no relationship with your students, it's really hard to get them to perform academically. And it's difficult to address any social issues if you don't have a connection with the student. And if you don't have a connection with the family, it's hard to maintain that whole entire loop with making sure that the whole student is learning. As the year goes on and you get into the academics, you kind of leave this and hope it just manages itself. And then I quickly realized reconnecting with them was important all year.
And we've grown to a place where we have class meetings where students speak their truth.
So I think it's really important to build relations with the students. They have to feel like they're in a space where they can make mistakes, and they can't do that if they don't trust me.
If you don't trust your teacher, then can't really tell her, like, how are you feeling?
Avery, I want to recognize you.
One commitment I made is to ask students questions that were not academic related, asking them something about themselves that I don't already know. We also started with some letter writing, in which I wrote them a letter and then I had them respond to me.
Excuse me, congratulations.
And we've kept that alive through the year.
You see it?